You want to interact with your system under test via easy-to-use interfaces? I will show you how easy-to-use and flexible the built-in solutions in CANoe are and how simple it is to set up your individual panel to interact with your system under test. Hello and welcome to this episode of our CANoe Getting Started series. I'm Christian and I will show you how you can stimulate and monitor your system under test with our tool CANoe. In earlier episodes of this series, we have built a CANoe configuration from scratch and showed you how to create a rudimentary hospital bed simulation. In this video, I will show you how to stimulate the bed's movement and its lamp and visualize the illumination and movement in a graphical panel. So let's dive in. In our hospital bed configuration, we have different CAN signals you can see here in the Symbol Explorer. What options do we have to monitor and set these? You have already seen the trace window where everything is tracked. When I start the measurement, we can have a look at the messages that are currently sent from the bed and the control unit. Here, we can see what is happening on the bus. For example, this CAN message. We see its timestamp, in which CAN channel it was sent, its CAN identifier, the symbolic name of the message, the event type, if it was transmitted or received, the length of the data field, and the actual data of the message. We see all the messages and their content in the trace. But how can we set a signal and manipulate its data other than in code? One easy way to manipulate signals is the Symbol Explorer. With a right click on the signal, we can choose Change Value and change the value. We can then see in the trace window that the head adjustment signal is set to 1 and the head position is going up. For automated value changes, we can also use the signal generator in CANoe. Here, periodic value updates, such as ramps or sinusoidal curves, can be configured as we demonstrated already in a previous episode. Let us change the value of the head adjustment signal that is sent by the remote. Using the Symbol Explorer and the signal generator are very quick ways to manipulate values. Panels are a more convenient way to stimulate and visualize your signals and other data. They offer versatile options and can be configured according to your needs. Let's see how that works. First, we open the panel designer from the Tools section. This is your panel. Up here in the Panel tab, you can configure the properties of the respective item. We rename the panel to Hospital Bed. Down here is our empty panel that we can configure with controls from the toolbox on the right. We see all kinds of different controls visualizing inputs and outputs. For our hospital bed, we start with a picture box. Under Properties, I choose the image of the bed via this file dialog. To visualize the position of the head unit, we use a track bar that moves up and down depending on the head position signal that is received by the bed. We place the track bar next to the bed and adjust its properties. First, we want to have it vertical. Then we need to connect it to the head position of the bed, which we can find in the symbol selection window. We adapt the value range to the full value range of my head position, which is from 0 to 255. For the buttons of the control unit, we add a button element, which can be found right here. Again, we adjust its properties and link the head adjustment signal to the button. When the button is pressed, the signal shall assume the value -1. We also want to change its look, so we choose an image from the Appearance section and delete the text saying Button. We do the same for the button up. We add the head adjustment signal so that the pressed value is +1. To switch the light on and off, we add another button that is linked to the light toggle signal. The only thing that is still missing in this panel is the light of the bed. We can visualize the illumination with a picture showing the light cone. Again, we choose a picture box from the toolbox and choose the respective image. This time we also give it a name, because we are going to use this name in the code that switches the visibility of this image whenever the respective signal is received via CAN. We simply name it Light On. Finally, we save the panel and add it to the CANoe configuration. We are still missing the logic to toggle the visibility of the image on and off. Whenever the bed receives the signal light with a value of 1, the light cone in the panel shall be visible until it receives a value of 0 in this signal. Therefore, the command to show the light cone in the panel is implemented in the script of the bed, the so-called application model. Application models can be written in Python, C#, or Kerpl. As previously, we use Kerpl and add the logic to the same file. The light signal of the bed is set here, so we simply add the command to show the light cone here. To do so, we use the setControlVisibility command. When we're uncertain about the function's signature, we jump to the help page and have a look. Here we see that we have to give the name of the panel, the name of the control element, that is the picture box in our case, and a 1 or 0 to indicate whether it should be visible or not. So in our case, that's hospital bed for the panel and light on for the control name. We want to set the argument to 1 when the light is switched on, and we wanted to set it to 0 when the light is turned off. We simply set the argument to the value of the signal. After we save the code, we are now ready to see it in action. When starting the measurement and pressing the button up, we can see that the head adjustment signal in the control unit data message is set to 1 and the head position in the bed data message increases. In the panel, the slider on the track bar is moving up. When I press the button down, the head adjustment signal is set to -1. The head position of the bed data decreases and the slider is moving down. Let's try the light. When we click on the respective button, the light toggle signal is set and the light turns on, just as we implemented in the Kerpl script. We have now understood how to use signal generators, the symbol explorer and panels to set and visualize signals. In the next video, we'll add a diagnostic interface for which we will use the Ethernet-based communication protocol MQTT. There's a playlist with all the CANoe tutorials of our series. You can find the link in the description. For a deep dive into specific tools and topics, check out the Vector Tech tutorial channel. You can find a plethora of subjects covered there. Subscribe and hit the bell to not miss new videos. For any questions, don't hesitate to contact us. Thanks for watching. See you next time.